I'm Feroze Gujral. I run the Gujral Foundation and the Outset India, both contemporary art and design related philanthropic organizations. And when this project came up of actually having an opportunity to help with the Biennale, I just jumped at it. I'm extremely delighted to be their patron and ambassador, and having got Aspinwall for them to use for this incredible, incredible project. I think this edition, particularly being the second edition, is really, really important for us. I think the world, the first time was very generous. They looked at India favorably. They looked at us favorably. We were small, tiny. It was a heartfelt dream, like emotional thing to do for a very small group of us. And there were a lot of non-believers. This time, we are hoping to convince the world to believe. And I think this Biennale, in that sense, is supremely important. I've been to many Biennales worldwide, and I find that we are long awaiting one in India. Very often people ask me, you're from India, when is your Biennale? And one always has to say, we don't have one. So I think that it's not just us desiring this for our community, for India, for the amazing heritage of arts in India, both contemporary and ancient, but it's also really to say that we are not a small country. We're a very important populace. We are 1/3 of the world's population. We should not be ignored. Our platform should be the highest, the best, and the most aspirational for the world. And I think that people are beginning to feel that. And I think this Biennale is as important for us to give out to the world as it is for the world to come in and see us. So there are plenty of institutions, museums, people I know actually gearing up to come and see this and putting it on their calendar. And I think that's going to be amazing. So this is exciting. What was important for me as a patron, and why I urge other people to actually become patrons of something like this, is that what it does is it allows you to bring your gifts and your abilities, your skills, your patronage, your money to an idea that is larger than yourself. And when you do that, what happens is that you actually become part of a movement. And when you become part of a movement of a time in your own country, in any country, then that is history. So for me, I saw it very clearly as a very small step towards being part of a historical movement. And I feel that people don't realize that. People look at it from a distance and say, oh, some art thing is happening in the South. Oh, why is it in Kochi? You know, it doesn't matter. It's happening in India, one. Two, Kochi is spectacularly beautiful. It's a very high tourist destination. Kerala is a place everybody knows, right? It's not like where in India. It's a well-versed destination. And it's also, I think the fact that it is on the sea, it's a trade route, it's a spice route, it's a historical colonial city. And there is a lot of this mix which makes it kind of, I would not say global, but has a potential of like a global intent. In a sense, it's not an isolated tiny village in India, you know? It has a lot of history. And I think that's important location-wise. But more important for me was actually following somebody into the sunset with a great idea, which is a historic moment. And I think very few people saw that, which I feel sad. I'm not glad that I'm one of the few, but I just feel sad that people didn't, in our own country, see that. And I hope that they do now. And we are trying to raise funds, trying to raise awareness, trying to raise just a feeling of ownership that this is ours and to be proud. There's so little that one is proud of from this country anymore that it's just an incredible, incredible thing to do. And I hope many, many people sort of partake in the years coming, actually follow.